Here are some of the coolest Xbox controllers out right now. Whereas on PlayStation, no disrespect to them because I really love the DualSense technology, but the options in terms of colors, you can have a white one, a black one, or I've seen a red one, and that's not really as common as the other two. But with Xbox, a thing that I really like is that they put out all sorts of really, really cool controllers that are first party as well. Like I said, I have a collection of them right here with me, and a lot of them I haven't seen, so you're gonna be getting my first impressions and my first reactions off of them. Let's see how it goes. So we're gonna start off with the Forza controller. This is really cool and it's widely available. You can buy it right now. They released this alongside with Forza Horizon 5, and honestly, color scheme wise, one of the coolest controllers I've seen ever. And I really like the handles for this. Obviously with the series controllers right now, they have texturized backs, and right now they have a rubber grip. It kind of feels like I'm driving like a race car with this or something. Like I'm like have my hands on a steering wheel or something. And of course they have the textured back for the bumpers and the triggers as well. Overall, very cool. And like I said, they got that Horizon logo right there. This is like the first event that you play in Forza Horizon 5. So you also notice that when you hit the Xbox button and it turns on, it has a blinking light. It is a very, very vibrant kind of bright. I don't even know like what the technology is. It adds a really cool touch because you can see it all the way through the translucent front. And upon closer inspection, this D-pad is like got a little bit of like holographic energy, got like some translucent energy. It's more like a pearl instead of just a regular white. So next up we have this Places and Faces controller. Places and Faces is an apparel brand. And this controller came with this cool little bag that you can carry around your controller in. As you can see, it kind of has like an ombre. I learned that word from my wife, kind of like coloring to it. I really like this D-pad. It has like the two-tone white on black situation. I think that's really slick. They also have a logo on the back right here for the Places and Faces brand. Okay. Yes, I'm receiving word that it's not Places and Faces. It might be Places plus Faces, so don't roast me in the comments, please. That, you know what, now that I'm thinking about it, that might explain this two-tone D-pad, because it's obviously a plus instead of just a regular D-pad, right? But other than that, it's basically just like a standard series controller, share button in the front, texturized grips on the back, also on the, well, it doesn't seem like there's a texture on these little bumpers right here, but there is a kind of like a texture grip on the triggers. If you're tuning in for the first time, my name is Ray. I would very much appreciate it if you went and followed Stay Xbox Ready on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. I'm most active on Twitter, if I'm being completely honest, and I would very much appreciate it if you follow me there. So I thought this next controller was just gonna be a standard robot white controller. But when I opened up the box, imagine my surprise when I find a trolley gummy worm controller. And how do I know a trolley? It says trolley right on the back. But as you can see, it's like a blue, pink, the best flavor of gummy worm, in my opinion. I think a lot of other people share that opinion as well. And you kind of got like a derpy looking like gummy worm kind of just judging you while you game. And it kind of feels like just a regular black Xbox controller with just like a skin on top of it. So yeah, the feeling is kind of like so-so in terms of like the actual feel on the front here. I think this is funny, like this little guy is funny to me, and I'm personally a big fan of gummy worms myself. For that, it gets points, but overall, I'd rate this controller like a 5 or 6. Next up, we have a special Back for Blood controller. I don't think this is an official controller, but I don't think it's just like a skin. Obviously, a lot of gore, lots of zombies, lots of shooting. You got a huge splattering of blood, but it's kind of like gross coagulated dried up blood kind of splattered across this white controller. And of course, having the white base really makes that blood pop. It really makes it sing. So the front of this is really, really smooth. You can even say that it's a glossy finish. But other than that, it's really just kind of like a standard Xbox controller. I say this like a million times, but the texturized grip on the back, on the triggers. But you also have the Back for Blood logo on it. So pretty fresh. So I know that they sent this out alongside a press kit that included like a bomber jacket, but you know, at the end of the day, really nothing too special about this controller. It's just kind of like a white controller with like blood smattered all over it. I will say it also feels a little bit heavier than a regular Xbox controller. I don't know if that's intentional and what that does, but I thought it was worth mentioning. So the next controller, and this is something I talked about in one of my early videos, is the Aqua Shift controller. And honestly, next to the Horizon controller, this color scheme wise is like, I guess, aqua would be pretty apt in describing this color. But what I really like about this controller, just kind of seeing it out the box, is they differentiate on the back plating, kind of the grips for the controller right here, with like a different, like, I don't even know, like lava lamp blue action. I can't even describe it to you. I kind of roasted the Back for Blood controller kind of being like a basic controller. This is like a basic controller, but it's like, I would rate this like way higher. Like I said, the color scheme, I like kind of like the matte finish that's not like super glossy. And the best thing about this is that you can go into a store and like actually physically buy this. You don't have to go into like a crazy pre-order queue, fight a bunch of scalpers. You can literally buy this at like a Best Buy, Target, whatever. This is just a $70 controller, as is the standard nowadays, but it goes on sale all the time. I've seen it as low as like $65, $60, and I'm sure that they're gonna have a sale for this going on for Black Friday. I have another blue controller here. Bam, this one. I talked about this one in one of my first videos. This is the controller that leaked. It was one of the first special edition controllers Xbox released for the Series X. As you can see, it's blue and it has white on the back, Sonic colors. I had people saying, oh my gosh, are they gonna buy Sega? This is crazy. No, this is just like a blue controller, guys. I really like blue as a color. Obviously, I'm wearing it in my jacket right now. I always wear my jean jacket as well on the channel. And this is a pleasing color of blue, not quite as pleasing as the Aqua Shift. As you can see, you can compare the two for yourself right here on the channel. Pause it, zoom in, whatever you have to do. I think what's interesting on this one is that you have obviously the YBAX buttons right here, but you also have like the color coordination, like little dots in the middle. A red dot for B, green for A, blue for X, and yellow for Y. I'm not sure how helpful that is because I don't know how many people go by pressing these buttons in terms of the colors, but it's definitely there if, you know, you're playing a game and it says like, oh, press the red button and you're like, oh, which one's red? I don't. So this next controller is from Pope Art. I've talked about him on the channel before. He's on Instagram. He does all sorts of cool designs for the Xbox controllers. And this one is one of his most popular ones. It's the Needler one, modeled after the Needler from Halo. And what I like about this controller off the bat is the variety of colors. So he's matched up the color of this analog stick to the kind of color, the gray on this side of the controller, and has a purple analog stick and D-pad for the purple side of the controller as well. So the duality of that, I really appreciate. Obviously you have a nod to the actual Needler ammo, you know, the stuff that you get shot up a bunch with and then explode. I'm sure a lot of people have a lot of rage memories of being killed by a Needler. It's kind of like a cheap way to die in Halo. Another thing that's interesting is that it has kind of like this blue kind of connection to these buttons that make them, give them their blue color, I guess. On the back, you'll see that this kind of like two-tone aspect for this controller carries over. So you have the gray part, purple part. What I think is interesting is this pink trigger right here. It's kind of like, I mean, obviously the main thing that you would use to shoot in any FPS. Overall, you know, I like the design of it, but now that I see it in person, the feel of it is kind of like, eh. So, you know, so like the design, yes, 10 out of 10. Feel of it, it's just a regular controller, honestly. So if you get this, you're in it for the looks. But the looks cost a lot of money. This controller goes for $150. So I'll let you be the judge on whether or not that's worth it or not. So next up we have three Space Jam controllers. I don't have three hands, so I'm gonna do them one at a time. If I did have three hands, I would be like unstoppable when it comes to like any game, but I don't. So we're gonna do it one at a time. So first up, we got this one. Oh, okay. We have it right here, clear as day. And let's see, open it up. Okay, I like this. I like this. Again, blue-ish controller. I'm really vibing with that blue, right? And on the front, it's like future Warner Brothers, like kind of like nods to Looney Tune characters as well. I'm not sure what the design is, but like it's cool. It's like tech Looney Tunes Warner Brothers. But on the back, yep, you see a little bit more clearly the baby blue color on the front for these analog sticks and things like that. And of course you got the Space Jam logo right here. I really like this. I don't know. I can't really put into words, but I vibe with this controller, man. It's just a feeling, man. Next up we have this controller. This is like a Toon Squad, just a standard Space Jam kind of logo that they have for the new one with LeBron James, of course. You know, this one, like it has that kind of bluish kind of hue that I liked in the last one, but you know, something about it, I'm not really vibing with it as much. But they do have not overt nods to like actual basketball on this controller, so I do appreciate that. Again, I kind of like this two-toned kind of thing that they got going on right here. On the back, they have the orange right here that carries over from the basketball, and over here, they have like a different kind of blue that kind of, oh, they got like three different kinds of blue on this controller. So you got this kind of blue, you got this kind of blue that's also on the back and the bumpers, and then you got this kind of blue for the grip on the back right here on the left-hand side. And now we got a purple one, and this one, okay. Now this is the Goon Squad controller. Goon Squad. Baby. Okay, I see it. So you just have like that kind of purple color going on right here. Goon Squad and huge letters in the front. Now I see kind of like some stars on like the lower end of the controller for the grip. You got Goon Squad on the back and also the Space Jam logo. So if you're a fan of the Goon Squad, this controller's for you. Anyway, to wrap it up, I have the coolest controller of all. As you can see, the black on black with pops of color in the front. You know, I think they did it as a special edition for the Xbox Series X launch. It came with this controller specifically. It's gonna be super rare in like 10 years time. Trust me, guys, no. Just a regular Xbox Series X controller. That's it. I know there's a couple controllers missing. We obviously didn't review any of the Elite controllers from the Elite series. And I'm also really wanna get my hands on a 20th anniversary controller. So please, Xbox, if you see it, hook a brother up. Please, I really want that controller. It's the only one that I really can't get my hands on feasibly. A bag full of controllers and not one of them is a 20th anniversary one. It's sad, it's sad. So if you really like any of the controllers you saw in today's video, make sure you subscribe and let me know in the comments because I might be giving one of these controllers away soon. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. My name is Ray, and we'll see you next time.